Hello. So for some reason, I really wanted to see Windows Poop Edition running inside of a Windows XP virtual machine. So I did that. Now, you can't just run the original versions of Windows Poop Edition in Windows XP because they use version 11 of the Love framework, which drops support for XP. And even the next lowest major version, 0.10, doesn't run on this particular machine because it requires support for, I think, at least OpenGL 2.1. And this Windows XP virtual machine with no additional graphics drivers filled with or whatever apart from VirtualBox guest tools only supports OpenGL 1, I think, so that just won't run at all. However, the next lowest version from that, 0.9.2, is the latest version that will run on Windows XP and which supports OpenGL 1. So I backported Windows Poop Edition versions 2 through 4 to Love 0.9.2, but not Windows Poop Edition 5 because I got tired. First, I'm just going to explain a little bit of how I did that. I was actually able to backport all of these with basically not modifying any of the actual Windows Poop Edition code. All I did was have this one file, backport.lua, which contains code that does backporting, replaces certain love functions that behave differently in this older version or didn't exist at all in this older version. For Windows Poop Edition 2 specifically, it's actually a really small amount of functions I had to backport. Like, what is this, like three functions I had to backport? That shouldn't really be surprising. Windows Poop Edition 2 is like a really simple program. So yeah, this backport.lua just gets required at the okay, so we have a line editing issue here, but anyway, this file just gets included at the top of main.lua. So let's just run it. Yeah, audio playback is like really dodgy in this VM in general. I found that for some reason, continuously moving the mouse tends to mitigate it. I have no idea how the hell that works, but it just does. Anyway, we open the start menu. Yep, so it all works like pretty much exactly the same. I think the font looks a little different in its older version for some reason, but other than that, it's like basically the same thing. It all works, I think, basically the same. Yeah, even Minecraft works. It's really slow, but it works. Yeah, Windows Poop Edition 2 isn't really that interesting. It all works the same. I haven't found any issues with it. So anyway, that's that. I guess we can, shut that down. I don't know why that audio file played perfectly, but yeah, that's a mystery. We'll never know. Anyway, Windows Poop Edition 3. Now, this one was a little more complicated to backport because it required me to backport methods of love objects. So, backporting standalone love functions like this, like all this, is pretty trivial. Backporting methods of love objects is a little trickier, but it is just barely possible. Now, the thing about Lua is that it isn't really supposed to be able to modify the meta tables of arbitrary C data. But it technically is through the debug library. So we have this debug set meta table, and this backport.lua just makes a cursed usage of this to replace, well, technically not replace, it doesn't overwrite the C data, but it sort of directs it to our own little table that provides new functions. The Lua manual kind of explicitly says to not use this library for anything other than debugging. But I did anyway because I hate you specifically. Anyway, that's enough technical preamble. Let's just see how this runs. Okay, so it crashes instantly, which I actually already knew about. So this error message gets cut off, but it actually says, "Sorry, your graphics card does not support shaders." And that's because it's trying to load G3D, a 3D library used by the 3D Epicness program, this early. Because for some reason, Windows Poop Edition 3 loads every single one of its programs right on startup instead of loading them as the user runs them. Because that's just how I decided it should work back then, for some reason. So this is kind of just what happens every time you start it up, but it's okay. You can just press R to bypass it. And yes, that's supposed to be a Windows logo, the checkboard thing. Just don't question it. That's just what happens. This is Windows Poop Edition 3. It works okay-ish, I guess. If you try to open Internet Explorer, see, it plays an error message, of course. It plays an error sound. And this is something interesting that happened while I was backporting this. I actually technically had to replace some of the files in here, specifically the sounds. So it turns out that in the original Windows Poop Edition 3, these sounds, so everything except for the startup sound, was in a sample rate of 22,050 kilohertz, which is half of the standard 44,100. And for some reason, Love 0.9.2 just really can't play those properly, and I'll show you what I mean. So here's a version of it with the original sounds, and if you try to run it, it just crashes instantly. It always crashes instantly on this virtual machine on Windows XP, but I'm going to show you what happens when I run it on my host computer here, and it'll either crash instantly or it'll load, but something weird will happen. Let's see. Okay, that time it crashed instantly. Let's try again. Okay, there we go. Now it loads. Something interesting happens when we try to play any of these error sounds. Yeah, so as I said, Love 0.9.2 apparently really can't handle 22,000 kilohertz files. 22 kilohertz files. Apparently the decoder just does some sort of out-of-bounds memory access, which either results in a crash or results in glitched ass audio being played. So, you know, that's pretty great. Let's play another error sound. Okay, that one was less noisy, but it's still glitched to hell. So, it already kind of works. Oh, what the f- That's just what sort of happened. So I kind of had to replace the 22 kilohertz sounds. And File Explorer, all the files work. I am running Windows Poop Edition 3.0 inside Windows XP inside Windows 10, holy cow. All the file operations work the same. Except, moving files doesn't work. Like, if I try to rename, so like hello.txt or something, it doesn't work. Now, that's not a problem with the backport. That's a problem with Windows Poop Edition 3 itself. Moving files just doesn't work, and somehow I never noticed that. And I forgot the reason why it doesn't work, but it's some really stupid, ridiculous programming error. Notepad works the same. At least I think. I don't think there's any issues with it that I've encountered thus far in my, like, 2 minutes of testing, so yeah. Paint? Unfortunately, Paint does not work on this virtual machine because apparently the OpenGL implementation does not support canvases, CanVibe, so yeah, but it does work. Like, in order to get Paint to work, I did backport functions like love.graphics.ellipse by basically just copying the C++ implementation from later versions and translating it to Lua. Control panel, this all works the same. It's, yeah, pretty mundane. Command prompt, this works. You can list available programs. You can open arbitrary programs, including the start menu, which, fun fact, is a program. The start menu is its own programming Windows Poop Edition because that's just how it works. And then we can completely crash the computer from the command prompt. Yay! Importer. Now, this is one program that just doesn't work because Love 0.9.2 doesn't support dropping files onto the window. It just doesn't support that. So that's functionality that just doesn't work. Sound recorder. This one doesn't work. It displays the black screen of death. And again, this is not a problem with the backport. This is a problem with Windows Poop Edition 3 as a whole, because this is just what happens when you launch Sound Recorder on a system that has no available audio recording devices. So yeah, Windows Poop Edition 3 just assumes that you always have at least one microphone device connected, and if you don't, it just crashes, because I sucked at programming in 2021. And since Love 0.9.2 doesn't support audio recording at all, it just always acts as if there's no microphones connected to the system, so that's why it always crashes. UCAN code. I haven't technically tested any UCAN code programs apart from the sample one that gets included by default. And again, it's really freaking slow, but oh well. So there might be still some random UCAN code commands that might not work as intended, but I haven't tested those, and I don't know if I care that much. 3D Appingness, this is another program that doesn't really work. This old version of Love just cannot draw 3D graphics because that requires using custom mesh vertex formats, which Love 0.92 simply just doesn't support at all. Even if G3D did work on this Windows XP VM, even if this Windows XP VM did support canvases and whatnot, supported shaders and whatnot, that's what I meant to say, it just wouldn't work. And actually, I can actually show you that on here. I'm just gonna run it on the host computer here. Okay, let's not run the broken version. Let's run the version that actually works. So Paint works on when you're running on the host computer because this GPU obviously does support canvases. Even the ellipse function works. I think you can even load and save pictures. I don't know. I forgot if I tested that or not. But anyway, back on track. 3D Appingness just displays pure black because, again, 3D just straight up doesn't work. So yeah, that's like all the programs, I think, except for the media player, which, again, audio playback is dodgy as hell. Yeah, now it's decent, now that I'm moving my mouse continuously and it's caught up. And by the way, it always acts as if all audio files have a length of 1,000 seconds, because Love 0.92 doesn't have a way of getting the duration of streaming audio sources. Now, really, the correct behavior would be to return negative 1 second, because that's what later versions of Love do when it can't determine the duration of an audio file. But that doesn't really bode well with this Windows Media Player. It doesn't handle it very well, so that's why I have it just return some arbitrary large value instead. Yeah, that's all the programs, I think, in Windows Poop Edition 3. It's not really that interesting. Yeah, I guess you just shut it down now and move on to Windows Poop Edition 4. Now, funnily enough, this literally already works when you copy the backport from Windows Poop Edition 3 just into Windows Poop Edition 4. It just kind of already works. Let's just actually run it. And, it just already works, which shouldn't be that surprising. Windows Poop Edition 4 isn't that different from Windows Poop Edition 3, honestly. Yeah, these old Windows Poop Edition versions are kind of weird and geriatric because I barely knew how to program at the time. And you can try to play video. It won't work. It'll display this error message. Games, we can play Minecraft and the stupid blindingly bright Jomang logo. And the very, very good frames per second that we're getting on this. Single player, create new world. And it'll be even better once we get into the actual game. Oh yeah. What is that, like 4 frames per second at best? Yeah, so good. I imagine Stick Collector is gonna be even worse because, yeah, that's an even worse frame rate. Because I barely knew how to program back then, I did this stupid thing where I generate this background on every single frame. I regenerate this static background using a noise function or whatever every single frame, because I originally tried to do it with a canvas, funny enough. I originally tried to generate it only once and then just draw that canvas over and over, but I couldn't figure out how to get the canvas to work for some reason, so I just gave up and just draw this continuously generated the background on every single frame. And that's why the performance sucks, and that's also why I just replaced this with a solid color green background in later versions. I could probably bring back the noise background if I really wanted to, now that I don't suck at programming. Probably. I don't know, that's a bit of a stretch. This is, Dead Fish doesn't work because it uses canvases. This just instantly crashes. Yep. Yeah, 3D Appingness, again, obviously doesn't work. But at least it doesn't cause the OS to crash on startup, so that's a plus. Solitaire, this is, yeah, really good solitaire. Minesweeper, yeah, really good Minesweeper. Control panel, no items found. You can use this really fun soundboard which barely works. Okay, now it works for some reason. Now it doesn't. So good. Like, I did not expect it to be this slow. I mean, I probably should have, since there's, like, not really any hardware acceleration on this VM at all, I think, so that's unsurprising how slow it is. Yeah, so that's Windows Poop Edition 4. It's basically just a version of it that barely works and is the slowest thing ever. So, but the good thing, it's running inside a Windows XP virtual machine, which is, I don't know why I said that was a good thing, but it sure is mildly interesting, I guess. So yeah, let's just shut this down. Really good audio playback, of course. And yeah, that's kind of it for running Windows Poop Edition on a Windows XP VM. I don't know why I did this, but I just sort of did. And, yeah. Goodbye.